today.
Oh, how cool!
How lucky is this?
A close shave on a mobile barber shop.
What sort of money are you looking for?
I'd like 6,000 for it.
Can a big name in motorsport,
signed by Mr. Schumacher himself,
secure a winning deal?
Value-wise, you know, 50, 60, 70, 80,000 pounds.
And a conundrum over a rare bag. At Cashbrokers in Penzance, Neil and Larry are mulling over what to do with Gary's phone box. But they're distracted by an interesting package that needs to be valued.
That's part of the Formula One car.
It is.
Yeah, I know all about that.
Do you?
Yeah.
Enlighten me.
We've got a chap called Sam coming in soon to see us. Sent this down to us, and I'm glad it's arrived in one piece.
As well as the box's contents, 19-year-old Sam Randon has brought in a few other items for Larry and Neil to see.
Hello.
Hi there.
You Sam?
Yes, that's right.
I'm Larry, Neil.
Hi, guys. Sam.
We've got a box arrived for you.
Yes, that's the wing.
I hope you don't mind we looked in it.
No, of course not.
OK, we'll just go pop round.
Brilliant, OK.
Day to day, Sam Randon is an apprentice maintenance engineer, but his passion has always been motorsports. He's been racing from an early age.
Well, I started karting, as a lot of people do, such as the likes of Lewis Hamilton. Went through the ranks and it progressed into something a lot more serious. I'm racing a proper race car in the Michelin Clio Cup Series.
But the sport is very expensive and Sam is reliant on sponsorship.
Motorsport generally is funded by the driver. The driver brings the money in the form of sponsorship. So any crash damage, the driver has to pay for. And that can be devastating sometimes. A few weeks ago, we had a big one where the car was nearly a write-off.
To pay the repair bill and complete the season, he needs extra cash. And to help him, his father has given him a number of Formula One memorabilia to sell.
My dad's always been behind me since day one and is the main sort of driving force behind generating the sponsorship. So it's just as important for my dad that we finish the season and generate the funds to do so.
With just a few weeks to get the money and repair his car to rejoin the final race of the season, Sam's turned to pawnbroking for the first time. He's got six items he's looking to sell, including a signed replica helmet and the front wing of a car.
Hopefully, I'd like to make Dad proud, especially after he's had to part with these items. Maybe one day I can repay him by signing a helmet, having won the British Touring Car Championship. Who knows?
Right, let's have a look, see what we got.
OK. It's part of the McLaren front wing, I believe, and signed by Button.
Signed by Button, yeah.
OK. All right.
A certificate in there as well, I believe.
What else do we have?
There.
We've got Schumacher prototype boots.
All right.
Obviously designed for racing. Doesn't look like they've ever been worn. Couple of hats.
Couple of hats.
Sam's also got signed caps, gloves, and lastly, a replica helmet.
Signed by Mr. Schumacher himself.
Really?
Brilliant.
Yeah. OK, and certification for this as well?
Certification as well.
So all this was kind of yours and your dad's collection?
Yeah, I mean, Dad's been a motorsport fan as long as I've been alive.
Have you any idea what sort of number you need to raise?
I'll be honest, I don't have a clue.
No?
No, I really don't know.
But I think we need to have a good look.
Yeah, we need to do quite a bit of research because they're very specialised items.
Yeah, yeah.
Signatures, even though you've said you've got the paperwork, can be tricky, to say the least.
Well, if you can leave it with us, hopefully we can get a good number for you.
Yeah.
And we'll be in contact soon.
Yeah, brilliant. Thank you very much,
guys. Thank you, Sam.
Cheers.
OK, take care.
Thank you.
What do you think?
I really like these. I think they're fantastic. I'm particularly interested in the boots, which I think are very, very unusual.
Right, OK.
So I think they're very rare. It's not every day something like that walks in.
No.
So it's good.
Larry and Neil will need to evaluate the collection carefully. But will the sum be enough to cover Sam's repair bill and get him across the finish line come the end of the season? In Penzance, Larry and Neil are attempting to value a collection of Formula One memorabilia that racing car driver Sam has brought in. He needs the money to pay a huge repair bill after a recent accident.
It's going to make it a struggle for the end of the year, and that could alter the final championship standings. I saw this as the best way to make an amount of money quickly.
Our drive at the moment is to get Sam to the end of the season, hopefully finish on a podium, so next year is well set up to carry on racing.
To evaluate the collection, Larry and Neil have decided to call in sports memorabilia expert Jeff Mills.
Yeah. OK.
How are you doing, Jeff?
I'm very well, thank you.
Good, good. As you can see, we have a small collection for you.
Looks very interesting. What have we got exactly?
We've got, most intriguingly, some Nike racing boots.
Yeah.
Which were originally, apparently, a Schumacher design.
Well, when you mentioned these to me on the phone, they sounded really the most interesting of the group, because they are really unusual. We don't have any kind of authentication or proof
only
as to whether he wore them or...
No, just the Nike labels inside.
I mean, you can see they are actually handmade. These aren't a mass-produced piece at all. So that sort of backs up the story, which is good. No, they are very interesting. Mm. The replica helmet, I mean, as I'm sure you're aware, these are painted to look like the originals.
It's not flame retardant, it's not a race helmet.
It's a fake helmet, effectively, but it looks the part.
Yes.
And presumably it's got an authenticated signature.
It has.
This is, we've been told, off of Button's car from a Monaco race.
Right, okay.
2013, I think.
2013, okay. We can't sort of trace it or say this was used in a practice lap, this was or not.
I mean, it's got its serial number down inside there.
Yeah. Right.
Sports memorabilia has become a £3.2 billion global industry. The most valuable piece of sporting memorabilia is a New York Yankees jersey worn by legendary baseball player Babe Ruth in 1920. It sold for a record-breaking £2.8 million in 2012. So where do they start with Sam's eclectic collection?
I think it's better pricing things as individual items.
Yes.
Yeah, definitely.
I don't think it has an appeal as a group of items.
So thanks for coming in.
My pleasure. Really, really nice to have a look at them.
Jeff was very informative, gave us a lot of idea of price. Nice idea, you know, split the collection up, sell it to individuals. You'll get more money for it that way, which means we can offer more money to Sam.
Time to call 19-year-old Sam. But will the offer be enough to get him back on the racing track?
It's really important that we get these items sold. And I want to go racing, so fingers crossed, really. Hello?
Hello, Sam.
Hi, Larry.
We've had a really, really good look at the Formula One stuff.
Brill, yeah.
The helmet, you know, we knew wasn't genuine, but it is a genuine signature on it, which is good.
That's good.
Gloves are all genuine signatures, which are good.
Yeah, yeah, it is.
There was quite a lot of interest from the expert in the boots.
It's a pity there wasn't any paperwork
tying the boots to Schumacher.
Yeah.
It would have made them a lot more valuable.
OK, yeah, I see what you mean, yeah.
So what I can offer you for the whole lot, which I hopefully will be a great help to you, is £2,000.
Right, OK. I was hoping for a little bit more, but...
The helmet itself, if it was a real helmet, you know, 50, 60, 70,
80... £1,000.
Oh, I mean, really?
For a real
Schumacher helmet, definitely.
Well, I need all the funds that I can get, so, I'm going to take you up on your offer.
You know, I think, you know, the most important thing is to keep you racing.
Yeah.
Really appreciate the support, so thank you very much.
Thanks very much, Sam.
Cheers, Larry. Take care now.
Bye.
It's brilliant that we've bought the items. You know, it's great because I may pinch one or two of them, but we also, you know, have given Sam the ability to finish the season. We've now got great items.
£2,000 should hopefully put a good dent in the damage bill and allow me to finish the season and carry on up the ladder of motorsport and achieve my goals.
With enough money to pay for the immediate repairs, Sam's back on track in pole position with his racing future ahead of him.